Okay, let's start off putting things in perspective. We're going to change the oil on a 2013 F-150. And you're going to have to kind of scoot your way under there. But there is your oil pan right there and the bolt. It's a long bolt. It's one of the longest bolts I've ever seen. So have your carburetor ready and your drip pan to catch. But be patient. And you can crawl underneath your truck. Don't jack up a truck. Yeah, you can crawl underneath it. And your truck, don't let it be too hot so you don't get burned. So where is the oil filter? Okay, it's pretty easy to find. Just come up here, put things in perspective. There's a reservoir. And it is straight down there. You can see it. See that little orange thing? I've already changed my filter. So that's where the oil filter is. It's going to be easiest if you do all the work from below. If you try to do it up here, Ford loses a point or two because they have a hose is right in the way. Also, if you have another older Ford truck, your oil wrench is going to be too big for this one. This one is a small oil filter, just to put that in perspective for you. So I'm going to show you some tricks in a second, but work from the bottom of the truck, and that's how you get your oil filter out. This is tricky. You're going to have your oil pan. You see this big metal thing? Ridiculous. Parts of your oil filter will drip to the back of that, so be ready. Well, it looks like Ford is trying to help you, and they created this piece, which looks like some type of a long drip pan or something. But I had my oil filter oil reservoir underneath there at first, but that you'll see this when you get under your truck. But it's right here, and it's a plastic piece, and your oil filter is right at the top of it. So you can do all this from below. Luckily, I didn't need an oil filter wrench to take it off. 7.7 for the 7.7 quarts for the oil. Don't cheap out. Get good oil. I got the Pennzoil synthetic, full synthetic. Super expensive, but if you catch Advance Auto Parts, they'll have it on sale every other month or so. So that's the time to buy it. And so you're going to need a 7.7 quarts, and that's where it's going to go. So I hope that made life a little bit easier for you. And I put Pennzoil in my last truck, so I'll be putting Pennzoil in this truck. And this is the 5W20, full synthetic. Like I said, Advance Auto Parts, once or twice, three or four times a year maybe, they'll have it on sale. It'll come with an oil filter and 5 quarts. So take advantage of that. You know, you want to put a good oil in there. You can put the Motorcraft in there if you want. Don't put any oil in there. Make sure you follow the manufacturer's specs. You know, a lot of times you go to a oil shop and the first thing they do is grab whatever's on the shelf or whatever they got a deal on. So you might be buying a Joe Buck's motor oil and they'll tell you it's good for your truck. If you want to keep your truck a long time, I'd say don't do it. I'm gonna go and take the sticker off. That's the dealership I bought the truck from. So anyway, I hope this video helps you, and I'm about to pour my oil in.